Today in Welcome Back, we continue to learn about the web intensity or web motion. At the end of this video, you should be able to define intensity and use the relationship that I is directly proportional to the square of amplitude. And then you also learn how the intensity varies with distance from a point source. So first of all, intensity is the energy per second or the power transferred by a wave to a unit of surface area perpendicular to the direction of wave propagation. Well, this is something you can think back about Gauss law, which you learned in semester 2. The very important keyword here is that the area defined must be perpendicular to all the direction of wave propagation. For a point source, we will use a spherical surface which is perpendicular to all direction of wave from a point source. Hence, we have the formula of I is equal to the power divided by the area, where the area here is the surface area of a sphere, which is equal to 4 pi r squared. To conclude this topic, there are a few relationships we can identify from the formula. First, intensity is inversely proportional to the square of distance. Second, it is also directly proportional to the square of amplitude. And you just need to remember about this relationship which provided from the learning outcome. So combine the first and second relationship, we can see that amplitude of the wave is inversely proportional to the distance. So now, let's try a few questions. First is from STPM Past Year in 2015. The question provided the power and the distance, so we just apply the formula of intensity equals to the power divided by area, which is 4 pi r squared, and the answer is 0.016 watt per meter squared. Next is from the Past Year in 2017. It is given that at a distance of 50 km, the amplitude is 7.98 mm. If there is no energy loss to the surrounding, what is the amplitude of the vibration at the distance of 30 km? So here, just apply the relation we have learned that amplitude is inversely proportional to the distance. We have the ratio equations of the A1 R1 equal to A2 R2. So put in the values, answer would be 1.33 times 10 to the negative 2 meter. Last question is from Past Year in 2019. Instead of amplitude, you are given with the intensity of 20 watt per meter squared at a distance of 3 meter. To obtain the intensity of sound wave at a distance of 4 meter, the solution is almost similar with the previous question, except that intensity is inversely proportional to the square of distance. So we have the equation of I1 R1 squared equal to I2 R2 squared. Put in the value, you should obtain the answer is equal to 11 watt per meter squared. So this topic should be not a problem for you. So that's conclude my discussion today. If you still have any question, leave it in the comment section below. Also, do leave a like and subscribe to my channel. I will see you in my next video. Thank you.